What's up guys, Mike from Rockville, and today we're going to be looking at how to set up your portable PA RAM speaker. Now I have the RAM 15BT version 2 in front of me, but this is going to apply to all of the RAM PA speakers, whether it be the 12 or the version 1 speakers. Let's get to it. Now the RAM series of speakers are portable PA speakers, which means they have a built-in battery that allows you to use it without having to plug into the wall. This makes it super portable. So as you can see, you have wheels, increased portability, and we have a trolley handle. So you can use it locked into place just to hold it and carry it, but if you pull up on it, push this button in right here, and pull up on it, it'll lock into place, and then you can use it to trolley it around. This makes it very easy to take it from one place to the other. You know, you pull it out of your car trunk, you pull up the handle, and you just walk with it, and it's gonna roll with the wheels on the bottom. There's also two carry handles on the side, which also make it easy to move around. Now on the bottom of the speaker, we actually have a 30 millimeter socket, and that's to mount it onto a standard speaker stand over here. There's also a locking knob, so I'm going to loosen it, turn it all the way to the left really quick. So once it's all the way to the left, I'm going to line up the socket with the speaker stand. You're just gonna push down on it. Once you have it into place, you're gonna turn the knob to the right. That's going to lock it into place. And again, you don't have to use the RAM speakers on speaker stands. It just has that functionality so that if you want to, you can. All right, now I did mention that this is battery powered, so if you turn it on, it'll turn on automatically. But one thing I do want to show you is the charging light indicators. So I have an IEC cable here. I'm gonna turn this off really quick. The battery status indicators over here let you know when you're fully charged and when you're charging. So if I plug this in, you're going to see this light illuminate, and that means it's still charging, so it's not at full battery. And if it had illuminated green, it would mean I'm fully charged, I can unplug it, and I have full juice in it. So I'm gonna go back and turn it on. You're gonna notice right when you turn it on, the Bluetooth LCD display turns on right away. So I'm gonna show you really quickly how to connect your device through Bluetooth. So right away when you turn it on, it says no disc, please add disc. That just means you're in USB mode. So first what I wanna do is I wanna hit the mode button right here where it says Bluetooth pairing mode. It's going to say Bluetooth disconnected. Now on my device, I'm going to go to my Bluetooth settings and I'm going to find the RAM 15BT. It's going to come up as Rockville. You're going to click on that. You'll hear that chime to let you know that you are connected. One really important thing to note about the Bluetooth module is that it uses the MP3 line level knob over here for the volume. There's also a MP3 line button. So what this means is when the button is clicked in, we're using the Bluetooth module, the MP3 module. When it's clicked out, we're actually going to be using the line RCA inputs over here. So if you were using an old tape deck, an old iPod, something that doesn't have Bluetooth, and you want to connect it to this device with an RCA to 3.5 millimeter cable, you're going to plug that in over here, and you're going to make sure this button is popped out. Now, if you want to use Bluetooth, this button is pushed in, and then we can use our Bluetooth device as well as the volume knob over here. We can do a quick test, turn up the volume on the MP3 channel, turn up the master volume knob, I'll go 75% on each. Then on your device, you want to make sure it's at like about 75% as well. I'll turn it so you guys can hear, and I'll just play a song real quick. Cool thing about the RAM series of speakers is that they come with two wireless VHF microphones. Now, the great thing about these is you don't have to do any weird thing to pair them. They already come paired to the device and they all have their separate volume knob. Once you put the AA batteries in them, you're gonna turn them on with the front over here. There's three clicks, so in the middle mutes it, and then all the way up, turns it on fully. Now you won't hear me yet, but once I start adjusting the volume over here, you're gonna hear me come through. You're gonna hear me come through. And then this one has its own independent volume knob. So once I adjust that, you'll hear me come through as well. So you have two microphones. They each have their independent volume knob, which is really great because if you're using this for speeches or karaoke, you could have two people use it at the same exact time. Speaking about karaoke, you'll notice over here we have an echo effect. So if I turn that up, you'll hear the echo effect come into play. And that's gonna work with both microphones. Echo! Echo! Now, a quick thing about the VHF microphones, you want to make sure that this VHF power button is turned on, so pressed in. If you have it turned off, the wireless mics actually won't work. And when you're using the VHF microphones, if you're ever experiencing any little dropouts, you can always extend the antennas on the side over here. This is just gonna give you better reception and better line of sight so that the microphones never experience dropouts. Now, a really cool feature is when you're not using the microphones, we actually have two mic holders on the side here, these circular holders over here. You flip them down, you can slide the mic into each one, and they'll sit there nice and tight. You could even use it for transport. It's just a great place to have the mics if you're in a portable environment. Now, on top of the two wireless mics, you can also plug in a wired mic with the input over here. It's an XLR input. So I actually have a microphone and an XLR cable. So I'm going to plug the female end into the microphone, dynamic mic. Make sure this is off before I plug it in. Then I'm going to go and take the male end. Before I plug it in, I want to make sure the input is all the way down. I can plug it in here, turn on the microphone, and slowly bring up the level of the input. And you can hear the microphone is working. So on top of the two wireless mics, you can also plug in a wired mic and another input into the quarter inch input right next to it. And the echo channel will actually work for this microphone as well. Echo! That's pretty cool. Now, one really cool setup you could do is connect your phone through Bluetooth to the RAM and then pull up a YouTube karaoke version of a song. So I have Bohemian Rhapsody pulled up here. I could play it. And then I can use the microphone to sing for a full karaoke system that's completely wireless and portable. Now, a really cool thing about this is you'll notice there is a talk over button right here. If I put that on, you're going to notice that the sound of the music starts to duck when I talk into the microphone and then come back up when I stop talking. Hello? Hello? You notice how it starts to duck a little bit when I talk into the microphone. So if you're doing karaoke, you probably don't want that on, but if you're a DJ making announcements and stuff, you might want to have that on. Now, on top of Bluetooth, there's also SD card and USB input. There's a 5-band master EQ, so I can show you what that does. So if I play a song, I can boost the bass. You hear it starting to boost. I can cut it. I can boost the treble. I can cut it. It really just gives you a lot of control on how it sounds. Now, this is a completely rechargeable system, but if you're ever in the field, you're at a party, you're tailgating or something, and you have the speaker and you run out of juice, we actually have these battery terminals right here, so you can get power straight from your car battery. You would run a wire from the positive terminal to this red terminal over here, and then from the negative terminal of your car battery right to here, or you could ground it somewhere else on your car, it doesn't matter, but that will be enough to power this and keep the party going. So the battery compartment is actually over here, and we made a video that you can reference if you ever need to change it out. You can always contact our parts department if one of our batteries fail, which usually doesn't happen, but they'll send you a new battery and it's very easy to replace. You can check out that video as well. Now, a question we get asked a lot is, how do I integrate this into my already professional setup or into a bigger setup? And it's very easy to do it with the Line RCA outputs. So you'll see over here, it says Line Output, and it's two RCA jacks. So basically what you do is you take an RCA cable to plug the white into the left and the red into the right. And then on something like a mixer or another powered speaker, you're going to use this end and plug it into the RCA inputs. So I have an RPM 1470 here. I'm going to find my RCA input. I'm gonna plug it right in there. And now everything that's coming through the speaker is also going to go into my RPM 1470, which I can control independently. This is just great for bigger setups, and that's how you would integrate it into a professional setup. So hopefully this video showed you how easy it is to set up a RAM portable PA speaker. But again, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to reach out to our customer support team through email or phone number. As always, guys, I'm Mike from Rockville. I'll see you next time.